Let's start with a circle and two perpendicular intersecting chords. Let's say that the lengths of the segments of these two chords have the value of 2, 4 and 6. Can you find the area of this circle? If you want to try this problem for yourself, this will be a great time to pause the video and then come back and see the solution. Alright, in this video I will use three methods to solve this problem. The first method will be the method of perpendicular bisector. In order to start with this method, I will first need to find the missing segment of the horizontal chord. The easiest way to do this is to use the intersecting chord theorem. In this theorem, we have a circle, and in it we have two intersecting chords. We can mark those points of intersections as A, B, C, D and P, so that AC and BD will represent the chords and the point P will represent the intersection of these two chords. Now, if we pull the lines AB and CD, we can see that we have two triangles, ABP and the triangle CDP. This theorem will state that these two triangles are actually similar to each other. Now, using the rule of similarity, we can say that the product of the segments AP and CP must be equal to the product of the segments BP and DP, since those segments also represent the sides of our triangles. Now we can use this theorem in our favor. We can mark all intersection points just as in the picture on the right, and if we pull the lines AB and CD, we can see that again we have those two triangles. Now we will mark the section CP as X. So, if we substitute those values in our formula, we can say that the value of AP, that is equal to 2, times the value of CP, that is X, must be equal to the value of BP of 4 times the value of DP of 6. From here, it is easy to solve that X is equal to 12. So this is our missing segment. Now, we will continue with the method of perpendicular bisectors. First, we will mark the center of the circle as O. Now, if we take a look at the chord AC, we can see that it has two segments of 2 and 12. So that means that the overall length of this chord must be equal to 14. Now we will pull the perpendicular bisector through this chord, and we will notice that the perpendicular bisector must go through the center of the circle, and it will also divide our chord AC into two identical pieces of 7. So now we will try to find the length of this green line that represents the distance between the point P of the intersection of the two chords and the perpendicular bisector. Since the half of the chord is equal to 7 and the value of the segment AP is equal to 2, that means that this green line must be equal to 5. Now we will take a look at the chord BD. Since it has the segments of 4 and 6, that means that the overall length of this chord is equal to 10. If we pull the perpendicular bisector through it, we can see that it also divides this chord into two identical segments. So, this vertical green line will be the half of our chord, which is equal to 5. Now, we can pull a line from the center of our circle to the point D. This line will be the radius of our circle. And if we translate our vertical green line upwards to the point O, we can see that we are now forming the isosceles right triangle. From here, it is pretty easy to find the radius of our circle, since it is the hypotenuse of this purple triangle. So we will use the Pythagorean theorem. So r squared is equal to 5 squared plus 5 squared, so that means that r squared is equal to 25 plus 25, and r squared is equal to 50. And since we know that the area of the circle is equal to r squared pi, we can plug in the value of r squared. So, the area of our circle must be equal to 50 pi, and if you want to, you can approximate that into 157 squared units, and this is our solution. Now let's do our second method, and we will use the relation between the segments of perpendicular chords and radius. I know this sounds like a mouthful, but trust me guys, this is by far the easiest method. Let me show you. If we have a circle and two perpendicular chords, and we set the values of the segments of these chords as A, B, C, and D, there is one awesome formula that says that 4 times the R square is equal to the sum of the squares of all of these segments. To be honest with you, I did not know about this formula until a couple months ago. And when I found out about it, I was really amazed to see how easy it is to solve problems like this with this formula. If you guys already knew about this formula, please write it down in a section below, because I would really love to know how many of you actually knew about this. I sure didn't. So let's use it. We already know that the line CP is equal to 12, since we already got this value from the intersecting chords theorem, so I'm not going to do that all over again. We're just going to plug these values into our equation, and that's it. So 4R square is equal to 2 square plus 12 square plus 4 square plus 6 square. That means that 4R square is equal to 4 plus 144 plus 16 plus 36, and this would be equal to 200. So that means that R square is equal to 50, and from here, since we know that the area of the circle is equal to R square pi, we can substitute the value of R square, and we will get that the area of the circle is equal to 50 pi, and that is approximately 157 squared units, and again, we have our same solution. Now let's do the method number 3, and this is by far my favorite one, the analytic geometry method. For this method, we will first need to set our x and y axis. So I will set those axes so that they are overlapping with our chords and they intersect also at the intersection point of our two chords. Now let's continue by setting the intersection point A on the bottom. This point will have the coordinates of 0 and negative 4. We can do the same for the intersection point B, and it will have the coordinates of 0 and 6. Now on the left we have intersection point C, that will have the coordinates of negative 2 and 0. If we mark the center of our circle with a point O, we can set the x and y coordinates of this point as A and B. Now we will use the equation of a circle to solve this one. Just to remind you, the equation of a circle looks something like this, where A and B represent the x and y value for the center of our circle, and R represents the radius of our circle. X and y will be the coordinates of the random points of the circle. So, we are going to use this equation a couple of times in this video. Alright, let's first use this equation for the point A. We can substitute the values of 0 and negative 4 for the values of x and y in our equation of a circle, and we will get the following. Now we can simplify it, and if we put the a square on the right side of the equation, we will get that quantity of minus 4 minus b square must be equal to r square minus a square. Now let's do this for the point B. We will use the same principle of plugging those values in for the x and y. We can simplify it, and again we can put the a square on the right side of the equation, and we will get that quantity of 6 minus b squared must be equal to r squared minus a squared. Now we will combine these two equations together. As you can see, they are both equal to r squared minus a squared. So that means that minus 4 minus b squared must be equal to 6 minus b squared. From here, we can develop this equation further by using the formula for the square of binomial. Just to remind you, the formula for square of binomial will look something like this. So, if we implement this formula, we will get the following. Now you can see that we have b squared on both sides of the equation, so we are going to cancel them out, And if we put all the values with b's on the left side of the equation, we will get the following. Now we can simplify this to get that 20b is equal to 20, which means that b is equal to 1. Now we can input this value b in one of our two equations. In this video I will substitute the b in the second equation, but you can also use the first equation, it really doesn't matter. So we're going to get the following. Now we can simplify this, and we will get that 25 is equal to r squared minus a squared. We can rewrite this formula and say that r squared must be equal to 25 plus a squared. Now we will again use the equation of the circle, but this time for the point C. We will substitute those coordinates in, and we will get the following. We can simplify this, and again we will use the formula for the square of binomial to develop this, and we will get the following. Here we are going to substitute the value of b with 1 and the value of r squared with 25 plus a squared. And we are going to get this as a result. Now you can see that we have a squared on the both sides of the equation, so we are going to cancel it out. And we are left with 5 plus 4a that is equal to 25. From here we can see that 4a is equal to 20, so that means that a must be equal to 5. Now we have the values of a and b. And as I mentioned before, those values represent the coordinates of the center of our circle. Now we can find the distance between the center of our circle and the point b. This distance will represent the radius of our circle. Of course, you can also do this for the points A or C, it really doesn't matter. I just chose the point B. So for this one, we are going to use the equation of the distance between two points. And since we are already familiar with the coordinates of the point B, we can say that the distance OB is equal to the square root of XB minus A squared plus YB minus B squared, where XB and YB will represent coordinates of the point B, and A and B will represent the coordinates of the center of our circle. So we will plug these values in, and we will get the following. Now we will put everything to the power of 2, and we will simplify things underneath the brackets, so we will get the following. From here we can see that r squared is equal to 25 plus 25, that means that r squared is equal to 50. From here, we can again use the formula for the area of our circle, and that is r squared pi, and if we substitute the value of r squared, we will get that the area of our circle is equal to 50 pi, and of course, that is approximately 157 squared units, and this is our solution. Hope you guys learned something new from this video, and I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content. And of course, if you found another method to solve this problem, please write it down in a section below. And until next time, as always, see you guys and take care.